thanks for checking in. So today I'm doing an unboxing video, and the reason I decided to do an unboxing video was because lately I've been having a lot of trouble with a lot of my online purchases, whether it be missing parts, damaged goods, wrong items. I'm probably sure many of you have run into that problem, you know, with Amazon, Walmart, or any other online you know, people that, you know, do deliveries. But this item, you know, and a lot of that stuff is like $10 stuff, $20 stuff, and, you know, I can work with that, but it gets kind of frustrating when you got to keep, you know, returning the item, right? So, but today, what I'm doing is an unboxing of an item that costs just $100, but that being said, the item is a Schwinn Day Tripper cargo trailer for a bicycle. You know, you could tow items and stuff like that. Here it is. I haven't opened it up yet. It costs $99.99. That would be about, with tax, $107, I believe. And it was highly rated. It was affordable. And it was something that I needed because due to the fact that I live in an area where there is no grocery stores that are nearby. And so I don't have my car going. I have to use a bicycle. And going back and forth to the store either two or three times just for a week's worth of grocery shopping was not cutting it. So I decided, you know, I got the idea from some local homeless people. You know, you see them with their those trailers that they have all their belongings in, their toddler trailers. So I did a little research on Amazon. I did pick this up for $100, $99.99, $107 with tax. And, you know, so I'm going to do an unboxing. I don't know what, you know, condition it is. The box itself, as you can see, it did come in good condition. There is no damage to it. None whatsoever. It hasn't been opened. Still factory sealed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open it. I don't know what to expect. And, you know, could be some, you know, damaged parts. Could be some missing parts. There could be instructions in Chinese. I don't know, but I did do some research on YouTube, you know, in case there were some assembly instructions, and the only thing I found was Schwinn does have their own little YouTube channel, and it does show how you put on a coupler to the back of a bike to attach the trailer. That's the only thing I could find. As far as assembly goes, I don't know. Maybe it just pops up and, you know, snaps together real quick. Don't know. So we're going to, you know, take a look at it, all of us together. We're going to see how easy it is. And then after everything is assembled, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give it a test run right here in the cul-de-sac where I live. And we're going to, you know, I'll put some debris that I got laying around the yard and see if it holds up the weight and see how it feels, you know, dragging it around. That being said, let's go do this. This is the Schwinn Day Tripper, the Schwinn Day Tripper cargo trailer. So let's unbox this sucker. Okay, guys, so let me just go ahead and show you this. First of all, it comes with a flag. So that's not really part of the assembly I wanted to show you, but it does come with a flag in two pieces, and it comes with a little pouch that's attached to it. But here we go. This is what it comes with. Here it is. It comes folded up just like this out of the box, okay? I'm going to show you how quickly it comes together. But first, it also comes with two tires, and let me see, just let you know, they're partially inflated, so be aware of that. Make sure you have it inflated. As you can see, it's rubber, it's not hard rubber. It has tubes in it, I believe, so yeah, you will have to inflate it. So here's how quickly it sets up. Okay, basically it comes just like this in the box, just like that. It springs wide open. Comes with a little tarp that you can put over for your cargo. Now right here you're going to see there are two arms that switch, and they have a little connection thing, little snap-in connection thing. So you just go like this, line it up, pops right in. same as right here. Snaps in, okay? Now at the bottom, what you wanna do, when you attach, before you attach it to your bike, there's this arm right here. Let me show you. The other way, just like so, okay? You got your locking pin. Easily just kind of detaches. You remove the locking pin. It swings right out. Then you put on this other hole. You just put it right in, just like so. And just springs right, pop right in place. It's not going anywhere. With the tires, little safety feature. Prevents damaging the axle. Pop that out. I keep this just for safety reasons. For storage. You take it. You go ahead, you put the axle, the long end, right through here. Another locking pin goes right into the hole underneath, like so. Slide that right over, just like that. Then you do the other side. Fairly lightweight. I would say, I don't know, for me, it's probably about 10, maybe 15 pounds at most. Take it, long end, right in here. Got your little, like I showed you. Got your little locking pin. Right here, it swivels. You just put it right in the hole at the bottom. Attach it. Ah, come on, you piece of, I don't want to say trash, but it's really not trash. And there it is. There's the trailer. I mean, it comes together so simple. And like I said, I wish I could have showed you, but I deleted the files accidentally. But it comes out of the box just like that. And these are just little clips, as you can see, right here. And they just go right into place to hold down your cargo, whatever you're loading. Oops. How she did it. Really simple. And again, I remind you, make sure you have air in this tire. When you see my the next clip of me testing it out as I'm putting around the cul-de-sac in front of my home, you know, there is no air in this tire. I wouldn't recommend that with heavy loads, but it does say it has a 100-pound limit to it. Fairly light, easy to use. And again, let me just show you quickly how easy it is to disassemble. Now, mind you, right here, I don't know where the patch, there's a little place where you can put your flag. I don't see it right off. I can care less about the flag myself. Oh, a little Velcro. I didn't see that. Velcro on the sides. Boom, just like that. Right here. There will be two little things you just pinch. All right. Takes a little bit of. Come on. You worked easy for me earlier. There goes. Same with the front of the trailer. Right here. It is a little. That I do have to admit is a little tricky. Like so. remove the locking pin, remove the wheel. Oops. Same with the other side. And of course, the arm. Back down. Go ahead and replace that. And that's it. And this can go on the inside. There you go. That's how easy it is. All right, so there's the coupler. Now I put it all together. Let's go ahead and attach it. As you can see right here, there's a little clip right here. That's a safety feature. This will wrap around the frame of the bike. But basically, here's another one of those quick release. I think you see it in the sun. Just go like that. Pull out the locking pin. Insert it into the bike. Into the coupler, I should say. Just kind of line it up real quick. Just like so. Give it a little wiggle. Put it back in there. You gotta feel your way around. There it is. And then this, like I said, it's a safety feature. Just kind of go around here and do it a couple times. Or, yeah, just kind of go like that. That's it. Boom. Done. Look at that. There it is. I did put this on here, but I'm going to put this bucket, this bucket's full of cement. I'm just going to give it a test ride. I'm going to put it in there just to see how it feels. All right. Drop the bucket in there. And here we go. It's got weight. Oops. Yeah, what the hell. And there it is. So I'm going to give it a test ride. All right, here we go. Okay, so there you have it. That is absolutely awesome. That was absolutely money well spent. My review of this trailer is definitely a thumbs up. I think there's a 5-star rating on Amazon. Definitely 5 stars for me. Assembly, super quick. I barely, except for that one time that I just kind of reviewed over just a glance at the instructions, it was pretty much common sense. I mean, it just, as you've seen, it just folded right up and it was ready to go. Attaching the coupler, super easy. Just be mindful of make sure your rear wheel is properly aligned when you tighten it down. So I did that. When you see me biking around, I barely even felt it behind me. The only reason I did feel it behind me was because I did not inflate the tires. I kind of just did that on a whim. I probably shouldn't have, because when I made sharp turns, you kind of did feel a little bit of slugging around. The only difference I really felt was that bucket in the back was kind of just shifting around. That's because I didn't properly secure it down. But that's okay. It held the weight. That's about at least a good 20-pound bucket full of quickcrete. So, yeah. But I mean, for the most part, this little sucker right next to the big trailer, this little trailer right here is definitely $100 well spent, or technically $100 and $107 well spent. So overall, a Schwinn Day Tripper cargo trailer for bicycles, definitely a thumbs up. Highly recommend it. I hope you got something out of this. There's no videos I've seen out there on how to do assembly, probably due to the fact it's easy to do. I mean, a blind monkey could do it, you know what I mean? So there you go. Go ahead, purchase it. Don't be afraid. Thumbs up. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe, favorite, share it. Whatever they say and do on YouTube land, do it. Okay, thanks for watching, guys, and peace out.